Bonjour et bienvenue, c'est la modéliste et je suis contente that you are back here in my channel. For today's tutorial, we are going to learn how to pattern draft the corset top. A few days ago, I posted something on my community wall regarding this tutorial and I saw a lot of comments on the comment section that you guys are also excited to learn about this pattern making lesson. So I'm gonna stop my blabbering and let's get this tutorial started. To begin, on your pattern paper, trace your basic torso block. If you guys are new to my channel, I have a separate tutorial for basic torso foundation, and it is crucial that we use this design system to draft our corset pattern. By the way, we should trace the basic torso block but only until the waist. Also, we should pivot the shoulder bust start thread exactly at the side seam on the bust line. To pivot the dart, start tracing at the bust line going to the side seam and from the side seam until the center front and from the center front until the first notch at the shoulder bust dart. The bust line should be the starting point. Once you've reached the first notch, pause tracing. Using an awl or a pencil, poke at the bust point and close the shoulder bust dart to pivot it on the side seam. Continue on tracing until the bust line, which is going to be the end point. Et voilà, so now the shoulder bust dart is pivoted at the side seam on the bust line. Next, from the side seam at the waistline, mark in 3/8 inch or 1 cm to transfer the second front dart. And from this mark, draw a line towards the underarm side seam. To do this, temporarily close the side seam bust dart and redraw the side seam like so. Next, transfer the remaining 1 cm from the second front dart by distributing this 1 cm at the front waist dart. Divide the 1 cm and distribute equally. And redraw the front waist dart like so. And from the bust point, draw in your bust radius, but this is optional. Next, draw a line connecting the bust point and the front waist dart. And extend this line like so. This is the princess seam line. From the bust line, mark up 2 inches or 5 centimeters. And square a line for the front neckline. And extend this line like so. From the shoulder tip, mark in 0.6 cm or 2/8 inch. And from the underarm side seam, mark down 2 cm or 6/8 inch. And connect these marks, redrawing the front armhole. From the front neckline at the princess seam line, mark out 3.5 cm or 1.3 inches. From the new shoulder point, mark in 4 cm or 1.5 inches. From this mark, draw a line towards the mark at the front neckline. And this is the front strap. From the shoulder slope at the strap, mark down 0.5 cm or 1/8 inch. And draw a line blending towards the shoulder tip. From the princess seam line, mark out 0.6 cm or 2/8 inch each side. And from these marks, draw slant lines toward the bust point. From the neckline at the strap, mark up 3.5 cm or 1.3 inches. And from this mark, draw a curved line towards the princess seam line at the neckline. From the chest line at the strap, mark up 0.6 cm or 2/8 inch. And draw a slant line blending towards the armhole. Next, from the center front, extend a line downwards. From the waistline at the center front line, mark down 7 cm or 2.75 inches. And square a line for the hemline. And from the center front at the hemline, mark out 4.5 cm or 1.75 inches. Next, get the measurement of the front waist dart and record this measurement to be used for dart pivoting. From the mark at the hemline, draw a line towards the end of the waist dart, like so. From this new line, mark out half of your waist dart measurement. For instance, the half measurement of my waist dart is 2.1 cm or 7/8 of an inch. And from this mark, draw another slant line towards the end of the waist dart. And now we have pivoted the first half of the waist dart. Next, from the new waist dart, mark out 5.5 cm or 2.1 inches. And from the underarm at the side seam, mark in 5 cm or 2 inches. And connect these two markings, creating a slant line for the second dart. To do this, close the side seam bust dart temporarily and draw in the slant line for the second dart. From this new line, mark out the half measurement of your waist dart. For instance, the half measurement of my waist dart is 2.1 cm or 7/8 of an inch. Next, from this mark, draw a line towards the side seam bust dart to complete the second waist dart. From the waistline on the first dart, mark down 7 cm or 2.75 inches. And from the waistline on the second dart, mark down 5 cm or 2 inches. Next, temporarily close the waist darts. And starting from the side seam on the waistline, draw your desired shape for the hemline. And do not forget to hit the markings. From the center front on the front neckline, mark in 0.5 cm or 1/8 of an inch. And from this mark, draw a slant line blending towards the hemline. Next, on each corset panel, draw in the grade line indication. And cut out each panel from your paper. Before cutting out panels 2 and 3, close the side seam bust dart permanently. And continue on cutting out the panels. For the second panel, do not forget to close the contour at the strap. And these are my 3 panels for the front corset. On your pattern paper, trace your back torso block, but trace it only until the waist. And do not trace the waist darts. Next, from the side seam on the waistline, mark in 1 cm or 3/8 of an inch to distribute the second waist dart. And from this mark, draw a slant line towards the underarm at the side seam. From the waistline on the center back, mark up the same measurement from the waistline until the underarm side seam. For instance, my measurement is 21.2 cm. From this mark, draw a line towards the underarm at the side seam, like so. This line represents the back neckline. On the bust line, from the center back to the side seam, mark in the halfway measurement. And from this mark, draw a line for the princess seam line. From this line, mark out 1.5 cm on each side. And that is 3 cm in total. This is the new back waist dart. And from these marks, draw slant lines toward the bust line to complete the dart. From the underarm at the side seam, mark down 2 cm or 6/8 of an inch. From the shoulder tip, mark in 0.6 cm or 2/8 of an inch. And connect these marks, redrawing the back armhole. from the new shoulder point, mark in 4 centimeters or 1.5 inches. From this mark, draw a slant line towards the princess seam line at the back neckline. This is the back strap. From the neckline on the strap, mark up 3 centimeters or 1.1 inches. And from the princess line on the neckline, mark out 3 centimeters or 1.1 inches. Next, connect these marks by drawing a curved line for the back neckline. And extend the princess seam line touching the curved line. From the chest line on the back strap, mark up 0.6 cm or 2/8 of an inch and draw a slant line blending towards the armhole. From the shoulder slope at the strap, mark down 0.5 cm or 1/8 of an inch and draw a line blending towards the shoulder tip. And from the center back, mark in 2.5 cm or 1 inch and square a line for the new center back. Next, on each corset panel, draw in the grain line indication and cut out each panel from your paper. For the second panel, do not forget to close the contour at the strap. And these are my two panels for the back corset. And I'm going to put my desired sewing allowances for each panels. For the armholes, shoulders, and necklines, I have used 0.6 cm or 2/8 of an inch of sewing allowance. And for the seam lines, center back and center front, I have used 1.2 cm or 4/8 of an inch of sewing allowance. And I have left the hemline without any sewing allowance. Et voila! So this is the corset top on different angles. By the way, don't fret because I will make a separate tutorial for the sewing. So this is the front, and this is the back. Anyway guys, I hope this tutorial gave you enough tips on how to pattern draft the corset top. And if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to comment down below and I will reply as soon as possible. And if you like this video, give it a huge thumbs up. And if you super like this video, please give me a super thanks. And if you're not subscribed yet to my channel, La Modelise, make sure to hit that subscribe button and I will see you guys again on the part 2 of this tutorial. A bientôt!